Hi, Taurus. Happy birthday to you guys. Hope everything's well. Okay, let's get started with your reading. This is Empress, 33, Empress, 33. A lot of threes. All right, let's get started. Thank you for subscribing. If it resonates, please like, share, and subscribe. Taurus birthday. What is happening for Taurus birthday month? Taurus birthday. Taurus birthday. May. I'm sorry. Taurus birthday for May 2022. 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 Okay, yep. That's exactly what I was channeling. All right, Taurus. You guys are going to be making a wish this month. Or you guys have made a wish already, because that's what I was picking up before I started your birthday video. So yeah, you guys are making wishes. You're making a lot of wishes, and for a lot of you guys, a lot of wishes are coming true. Could be coming true in the month of May, because I am filming in April, but I see wishes coming true for you guys. You guys are really happy, because I'm getting, he's happy. So that's what I'm saying. You guys are feeling really good, really happy, kind of preppy. Just like, I feel like you're over the top this month. Like, you're happy. You got things to celebrate. Just happiness, a lot of happiness. Okay, so this energy is Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. And the overall energy of this card is Pisces, Nine of Cups. So yeah, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, but strong Pisces, okay? Yeah, I'm getting a lot of happiness. Yeah, and then this is a wish card, guys. So yeah, you guys definitely should make a wish. I know it sounds kind of cheesy, but yeah, make a wish. Because that's what I was feeling from the beginning. Well, a lot of you guys at the bottom, okay, of the deck, it's new job, new opportunity, a gift from the universe coming in. Very abundant. Some type of money opportunity. Let's see. Taurus birthday, May 2022. Taurus birthday, May for May 2022. Taurus birthday for May 2022. There we go. We have Ace of Swords. So for a lot of you guys, Taurus, you guys could be finding out some kind of truth, some kind of clarity. Or someone could be coming in telling you, you know, something. Something that you know, been kind of wanting to know, or it's something like that. You're going to find out something. But the truth is going to make you happy. That's what I'm getting, okay? So it's good news that you're finding out, or you're going to have clarity about. It's going to be really good news, Taurus. Yeah, I wouldn't worry about it. Oh yeah, look at this at the bottom. The Ace of Swords, okay? The main energy surrounding the Ace of Swords is the Ten of Cups. Oh my goodness. So, Taurus, you guys got a lot of good, happy news coming in. This is Ten of Cups, emotional fulfillment, stability. This is everything going perfect. It's almost close to perfect. You know, as perfect as it can get for you, Taurus. You guys got a good month coming up because I am filming this in April. So, yeah, for May 2022, this is the energy we're pulling for May, okay? You guys got a good month. A lot of happiness. I don't know. I'm taking it. All right. Then I'm supposed to put it there, I guess. Okay. Taurus birthday, May 2022. Taurus birthday, May 2022. Taurus birthday, May 2022. Eight of Pentacles. Beautiful. So you guys are working. Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus. This energy is Virgo here. You guys are working on something. Looks like working on your wishes. Yeah, something was a burden, okay? For some of you guys, I'm picking up that you guys are kind of switching jobs or, you know, changing jobs right now in the month of May, okay? So either you're looking for a job or some kind of opportunities coming to you regarding money, okay? Because with the Eight of Pentacles and the Ten of Wands, because it did fall out, it's still upright. Something's burdening to you. So the job that you're currently on, if you are currently working right now, in this month of May, work might feel a little bit overburdened, okay? You might feel like, you know, oh my gosh, I really need to get rid of this job. Like, you're just going to feel overwhelmed, okay, guys? And for some of you guys, this is how you're feeling already, and you're going to switch to a new job, because I seen that with the Ace of Pentacles. So that could be what you're getting clarity about in the month of May. Okay, you guys could be getting clarity on finding another job that makes you happy. Yeah, because the Ten of Wands came out with the Eight of Pentacles. Yeah, it's overloading. And see, he's almost, you know, about to fall over with these wands here. He's had enough. This is Ten of Wands. This is the highest in the deck. It's over. Okay, so for some of you guys in the month of May, you will be pretty much switching a new job, or, you know, doing applications. It's something like a switchover is what I'm feeling from this, because you guys are just sick of your job, period. You're sick of it. And a lot of you guys have had enough. A lot of you guys have already walked off the job, or you're going to leave, okay? A lot of you guys could be leaving in the month of May too, or just, you guys are just overburdened with it. It's a job you guys are just tired of. You don't like it. It's showing up here as it's just too much of a burden for you guys. And for some of you guys, you might have been there a long time, you know, or you got a position that requires a lot of stress and headache. Like, it's just too overwhelming all the time. It's like maybe like a lot of people are on your back, or it's just something like that. Let me see at the bottom. I keep looking. Yeah. Okay. Knight of Swords. I feel like you're ready to drop this burden. You could definitely be dropping it in the month of May. Yeah. So Eight of Pentacles come out. This is the main energy surrounding that Eight of Pentacles. So like I said, you guys got a heavy workload probably in the month of May. Maybe you guys are going to be working a lot. Okay. We have the Ace of Wands. Yeah. And the Eight of Cups. I'm getting another message, guys. So for this Eight of Pentacles, you guys are working a lot with the Eight and Ten of Wands. Okay, so you guys been progressing, because I did count. I said Nine of Wands, Ten of Wands. Okay, so you guys are putting in a lot of work on your job, and I feel like you guys feel like you're not getting nowhere. Like, it's like I do all this stuff. You know, I'm working all the time, all these long hours, and I'm still not seeing, you know, rewards. I'm not being appreciated. That's why I feel that for a lot of you guys, you're trying to switch jobs. I see that the switch, if you do switch, I do see it becoming better for you, okay? Because this is 9 to the 10 of Cups, okay? So you guys will be happy if, for those of you guys that are just tired of your job and you're ready to switch, you will be happy if you switch your job. That's beautiful. Yeah, because see, a lot of you guys are wishing right now with the Nine of Cups over the Eight of Pentacles. You guys are wishing, you know, to have like a better, like a job environment or a better workplace. I see it possible. I see it. Because it's like here with the Ace of Swords, you guys got clarity that you guys are ready to move on. You guys could have love coming in, because those hearts just flew out. Okay, so yeah, you guys could get clarity for love for others of you guys, okay? So Ace of Wands and Eight of Cups, that's what I'm saying. You guys are walking away. You're following your passion, though. This is Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. So the Eight of Cups is Pisces energy. And then we have the Wands, Ace of Wands. So this is Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Let's see here. You guys are bodying a lot of cup energy. So Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. You got swords. Yeah, you got everything here. You got all elements. You got earth, water, fire, and cups. Yeah. Pentacles. Got to do that. Excuse me.